Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we are continuing along with our Walking Dead reviews. After this, I'm going to do a couple Batman figure reviews, and then we will be doing miscellaneous stuff. I have some miscellaneous stuff and a couple more Star Wars things. And then I'll have some more stuff to review. So today's figure review is on AMC's The Walking Dead Series 8 Eugene figure. Now, what I'm trying to do with the McFarlane Walking Dead figures is get one of each character. And sometimes I get duplicates, like the same character, like Rick in different outfits. But I at least want one of each character. And Eugene was one of the figures I needed. One of my best friends has a friend that owns kind of a collector store, and he had Eugene and Bob, and he gave me a deal, so I couldn't pass him up. Eugene's one of those characters. He's okay, not my favorite character. I really didn't like him last season. I'm not going to spoil it. I hope what he's doing is for Rick's group, but yeah, so I thought I would review him today, and then tomorrow probably I will review Bob. I want to get all my Walking Dead figures open, so I have a couple of deluxe packs. I do have the Negan and Glenn pack. I know some of you guys were asking about that. I do have that, and I also do have the Morgan deluxe pack, which I will be reviewing too. But I wanted to do the single carded reviews first. So let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging. We have the AMC's The Walking Dead logo right there, McFarlane logo, Series 8, the New World's gonna need Rick Grimes, Eugene. Kind of a funny outfit. I was so shocked that he even got a figure in the first place. I'm glad he did, because, you know, he eventually would need a Eugene figure. But, yeah. And then there's Eugene, and based on the hit AMC TV series. And then the other characters in this wave are Bob, the, I think that's the Tyrese with that, the arm comes off, Dale, Morgan, Eugene, Rick Grimes, and Terminus Carol. I have all of these except Tyrese there. And that Morgan, because I did not get the Masked Morgan. I got him in the deluxe pack. So what I'm going to do is take a little bit of time and get Eugene out of the box. Stay tuned. Okay, and we are back with Eugene out of the box, and I'm kind of so-so about this figure. I kind of find it funny that they went with this outfit with his armor gear on, and not just a regular outfit. Not sure why that is, but let's go ahead and get into the figure. We're going to obviously start off with his articulation. He has a ball-jointed head, ball hinge shoulders, hinge elbows, hinge wrists, slight swivel at the waist, no swivel, hinged hips, ball hinged knees, and hinged ankle as the foot just came out. I thought I just broke it. Let's hope I can put it back in as I drop the figure. You gotta be careful sometimes with the joints on these figures, because they are delicate and they can break out, and I just thought I broke him and I wouldn't have been happy. Let's go over the detail of him. He has this riot gear on. He has this armor on, and I thought it was removable, but it's not. If you take it off, that's what will be under it. So I'm gonna have to super glue that. Same with the backside. I'm sure a lot of customizers can use this figure for, like, custom Eugenes, but I am not a good custom maker. So, but as you can see, it's just not meant to come off. And then under the right gear, we do see his jacket and his undershirt right there, which is nicely sculpted and nicely molded. You can see his right gear, shoulder pads, elbow pads, all on his arms and shoulders. You can see his half gloves right there. You can see his knee pads, thigh pads, I guess that's what you would call them. And you can see his boots right there, which are nicely sculpted as well. And then the back of him, you can see his green pants. And you can see his mullet, which is nicely sculpted and nicely painted. The face sculpt's okay. I don't really think the face sculpt resembles the actor or Eugene from the show. I think it could have been a lot better, actually, in my opinion. You know, sometimes they get dead on with the face sculpts, and then sometimes they get just, it's not there, and this is one of the times where it's just not there. I don't see the actor, really. Other than that, the detail is nicely done, and the sculpting is nicely done as well. He does come with accessories. Does come with this riot gear helmet, and I'm not sure if you can actually put it on. We can try, but I think his head is just a little too big because of his mullet. Yeah, you can't put it on. It's kind of just there for him to either hold in his hand, like so, or in his other hand. Sometimes. Like so, which you can do since it won't fit on there. But it is nicely sculpted, and maybe another figure could wear it if you wanted it to. He does come with this backpack, which, as I was taking out, it's kind of a weird, it did come off, and I don't think you can put it on. Maybe, we can try, but I think it's just going to be a very, tight fit. Maybe as one of the straps comes on, and then that would be really cool, because I'd rather, have him with the backpack on then like buy the figure or something. I like it when my figures can use their accessories, and even though one of his straps just came off, which is nicely sculpted backpack, you know, I might just leave it that way. So, and then he does come with this rifle, which is nicely sculpted as well. It's pretty big. Eugene, is one of those characters. At first, he's very scared to fight. He's very scared of the walkers, and, which I don't blame him. I probably would be too. I'm gonna take the backpack off for like 2 seconds. I would be very scared too, probably. But I think over time, the longer you live in that world, the longer you will, adapt. And, that's why I don't like it when they kill off characters, because, like, I'm gonna do this off screen. I would love to see, like, how, like, Dale, Lori, Andrea, Jesse, so many others, would be by now. He is not holding it for some reason. I would love to see how much they adapted, because characters like Lori and Andrea, especially Lori, were just trying to, at that time, it was still early into the show, they were trying to live just a normal, peaceful life. And I think Rick was too, but I'm gonna do this off camera. Okay, so I'm back. That took a little time. I was trying to put the gun in this hand, which it didn't work, so I put it in this hand. Unfortunately, it did kind of come apart, which I'm just gonna super glue once I'm done with this video. But yeah, just put it in the right hand if you can't have trouble. You will always want to be careful with these weapons, because they are very delicate. The gun is nicely sculpted, nicely painted, and nicely detailed. So yeah, that's all his accessories. This accessories are okay, not the best accessories, but this is not the best Walking Dead figure in my opinion. I just pretty much have him just to complete a collection. I do want to bring in Abraham, because when we first meet Eugene, he is with Abraham and Rosita, and I'm really surprised there's not a Rosita figure yet. I'm sure she's coming. I'm sure she'll be the next Walgreens exclusive. Well, actually, Negan will, but I'm sure she'll be after that. I'm sure we're going to get a Rosita before Lori, which really irritates me, but I hope they do, because then it will complete this pack. I actually think the Abraham figure is pretty good. I think the likeness looks just like the actor. See, that's... this is a case where they did a good job, and unlike Eugene, I think the figure is nicely detailed, I think it's nicely sculpted, but I don't think it looks like the actor very much, or the character in the show. That's just my opinion. You might feel differently, which is fine, but yeah, so, he's just gonna go be standing on a shelf for the most part anyway, so, but the Abraham figure I like, he's pretty good, and, I hope they do make a Rosita figure eventually. I'm sure they will. I see it this way, McFarlane will run out of characters sooner or later, and so they will have to make, like, a Rosita, a Lori. I would love a Jesse, but I don't see it happening, But that's going to do it for this review. Let me know what you think on this figure. Do you have him? Do you plan to get him? What are your thoughts on the character of Eugene? Are you his fan? Are you not his fan? Is he kind of in the middle for you? He's kind of in the middle for me. I'm kind of if he died, I'm not sure if I would be that sad, to be honest. If like a character like Carol or Maggie died, I would be probably really sad. But yeah, I just wanted to get him open and reviewed. Tomorrow I probably will do Bob. And then the next day I probably will do the Negan pack and the Morgan pack. So, and then after that we will focus on other reviews coming up. So I'm really excited to kind of get into the miscellaneous reviews, because I have a lot of stuff to review. So if you have any questions, let me know. Please subscribe to my channel. All my information is down below, as always. And until the next time, I will see you later. And I might be having a new fan mail address, if anyone's interested. I might not sure about that, but if I do, I will let you guys know, so we can start doing the fan mail videos again, if you guys want to, but we'll talk more about that when that happens. So, thank you for watching, and have a great day. Bye! Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.